Hey guys, what you doing? Are you ready for more exciting South Park info? Because I sure am. All right. Safety scissors. Run all you want with these. Well, scissors haven't really appeared in many episodes, but okay, let's talk about the episode called "Sexual Harassment Panda," because same because there is a mascot there called I mean, I don't know, but there is a mascot there which promotes running with scissors. So that's where this will come in. All right, so it's season three. Trey and Matt had just finished working on the movie and had just launched it. Or was that before? I don't know. During season three, they had the movie. They were working on the movie and they were kind of, tired and burnt out. And that's how they explained the episode. When they did the commentary, they didn't actually remember making this because, it was so long ago, and they were so tired. They described the experience as being on an acid trip, like everything is funny, and so they made Sexual Harassment Panda. The story behind this is that during that time, during the early, I mean during the late 90s. Sexual harassment lawsuits had become a real problem. So, if you said any, sorry, if you said anything, you could have been sued, and that was not good because Trey and Matt were like making dirty jokes, and they were kind of worried that someone would sue them for sexual harassment. And so they made it this episode, in which a mascot called Sexual Harassment Panda came inside the classroom and kind of instructed the children about sexual harassment, and it did so with fucked up pictures of baby pandas like humping other baby pandas' ears and pulling another baby panda's G-string. So yeah. And at one point, Kyle called Cartman an ass sucker, and that kind of led to Cartman suing Kyle and actually winning. And that's where everyone basically realized that everybody could sue anybody for sexual harassment and win. And the funny thing is that when a child sued another child for sexual harassment, the school also had to pay about $1 million or something. So yeah. And Kyle's dad, Gerald, kind of became Karma's lawyer, and then he started making TV commercials about and remember, losses are not about money. Wait, what am I saying? They are about money. If you're sad, then sue their asses with Kyle's dad, like. A little jingle at the end of the commercial to not make it suck so much. Because Sexual Harassment Panda brought about this whole lawsuit pandemic, as it were. The school board kind of fired him, and then he went to the island of misfit mascots. With the other mascots, which didn't make sense. And But before that, he went to Skeeter's bar, and that's where that is where you first get the joke with Skeeter, like, hey, we don't take kindly to panda bears around here. Now Skeeter, he ain't doing nothing. No, I want you to tell us something, Panda. How come you live in mountainous regions in China, but we bamboo who I mean, which is present at a lower altitude, huh? And then Stan and Carl come in search of the panda, and then Skeeter says, "Hey, we don't take kind to kids around here." Now, Skeeter, they don't do anything. Now, I wanna know something for Mr. Oh, I'm a kid here. How come you know? That whole joke. Then they find out that he went to the island, and they go to the island, and they convince him to return, but not as a sexual harassment panda, but as the don't sue people panda. And that's how the story ends, and it was quite funny, to be honest. And the sexual harassment panda had a little jingle, which was great, of course. Sarcastable trophy, a reminder that the world is all about hugging and safety. I talked about the sarcastable episode a few parts back, so no. School book brimming with dick drawings. There wasn't any episode which featured school books, so screw this. Screwdriver, both tightens and loosens screws. Yet again, no context, I think. No episode featured screwdrivers. Well, except for that one where Mr. Aller t told the kids to not screw around. So that was great. Seaman action figure, super sidekick swallow not included. Okay. So Seaman actually got featured the first time in South Park in the episode entitled "The Super Best Friends." That was back in season 5 when showing a picture of Muhammad wouldn't get you killed. That kind of happened with that. I think it was a Netherlander. A Netherlander journalist kind of drew a picture of Muhammad and then got killed. And because of that, South Park did, I mean, tackle this topic about censorship and the First Amendment and the show, but this is before that controversy, so no. The whole story features around Davy Blaine, Jesus, and the Super Best Friends. It starts off with Davy Blaine, who of course, if you don't remember him, was this super popular street magician. I don't know if he's popular today. I haven't heard of him in some time. By the way, so he's doing tricks. He's he's awing the public. He tricks Jimbo like, okay, Jimbo, now put your hand up your ass, put your hand up your ass, and he freaking pulled his card out of there, shit like that, and they introduce the concept of cults, because Blaine had a quote unquote religion, which is actually a cult. And this should be said, this was actually a their first kind of commentary about Scientology, but it was veiled. Their second commentary on Scientology was a bit was explaining exactly what it was, and the third one it was a parody, but you knew what it was. But this was, of course, the first one. So you know, he offers them his Blaintology book, you know, Blaintology Scientology connection. I think so. And he invites the kids to you know, to participate in the show, and then you know, to convert people, etc., etc. This should be said. They kind of made David Blaine finish his sentences with a twa, you know, like, hey, let's go somewhere and twa. And that actually came from a friend that Trent Matt had when high school, I think, who did that. He ended his sentences in twa, so they made David Blaine the same. And also, David Blaine kind of contacted them and told them that people were actually calling them asking for his Blaintology book, which was awesome. But yeah, you know, they joined the cult, and then Stan has second thoughts and leaves the cult, and then people keep pursuing him for some reason. You know, threatening him and such, but then he goes to Jesus and asks him to go to this huge David Blaine show and show the crowd that David Blaine wasn't a real thing, and then it's a sort of magic battle between Jesus and the Blaine. So first off, David Blaine eats his own head, which how the fuck that happens, I'm not sure. But then Jesus comes and he says, "Yay, these are all parlor tricks, gentlemen. But you know, real magic is much grander." And he does his whole trick of multiplying the fish and bread. And he goes like, "Here you have two fishes and three breads. Now you can't feed a crowd with that, but if you please turn around, turn around." Then he like he then pulls fish and bread out of his you know, trunk and freaking paws them up and says, "Ta-da!" And then like David Blaine levitates them, and then Jesus like pulls a coin out of David Blaine's ear, but then David Blaine kind of turns himself into cards, you know, floating around. And then Jesus realizes that David Blaine is much more powerful than him. And as his cult grows, David Blaine goes to Washington with his followers to make the government declare them a religion. And that kind of pisses off Jesus because, you know, that's not a religion, that's a cult. And so he calls up his super best friends, which are Jesus, Muhammad, Joseph Smith, Krishna, I think, and Seaman, which of course they all pronounce Seaman, and his partner Swallow. And I think it's oh, the guy on which Taoism is based, I think his name is Tao, actually, yeah. And Tao, of course. Did I miss anyone? So Christianity, Buddhism. Oh, and Buddha. Yeah. So Buddha, Krishna, Tao, and whatever I said. Those guys. And together they are the super best friends, saving the world from destruction and doom. And they make a plan, you know, they try to undermine David Blaine. But it don't succeed. Then David Blaine kind of brings the statue of Abe Lincoln to life. But then the super best friends. Oh yeah, and Moses is also a part of this. Moses a acts as their mainframe, you know, as their computer. And when they ask him how can you stop a giant Abe Lincoln, he says a giant John Wilkes Booth, and then they build a giant John Wilkes Booth, you know, like Jesus using his carpenter powers kind of builds some you know builds a mold, and then Seaman get some water, and Muhammad being fire kind of helps too, and together they make a giant John Wilkes Booth statue, which Krishna takes possession of and shoots Abe Lincoln in the back of the head, and thus they are saved. And then of course it's that whole thing with us. Ah no. You have beat me, super best friends, but we shall meet each other next time. And to be continued, even though they didn't continue it till this day. And it's sad. And then Kyle and Cartman kind of learn a lesson that, you know, cults are bad and you shouldn't join cults and, you know, love your friends, basically. Oh, and one more thing, they all, the followers protested by killing themselves in the reflection pool, and by drowning, you know. But they actually found out that the reflection pool is actually like a few centimeters deep. They had to freaking lay down. That's fucked up. But anyway, Shakeweight, I think I've discussed before, finishes off your workout with a refreshing blast of liquid. Did I talk about that episode? Let's see. C. No? No cream fraiche? Not even cafeteria fraiche? There we go. Okay, so I've talked about the episode The Shakeweight is in, Search for Queen Freach. Shattered Arrow will never injure a little brother again. Okay, so nothing interesting here. Shattered Simtar Blade. Real Simtar, but smells like Lionel Richie's asshole. What? I don't get it. Is. Well. Lana Rich hasn't appeared in any episodes, but I guess they say that Lionel Richie really likes shoving Simtars up his ass. Anyway, shredded plastic not destined to be recycled, because fuck recycling. Small locket, keepsake from a deceased loved one, no real value. That's it. Small paw, some are lucky, some are cursed. This one is neither. Yeah. Okay. Next we have soap on a rope, but we shall talk about that next time. So, bye.